If your site is dedicated to fact-check information on a web, such that when someone searches for a claim, on your search results, you will see a rich snippet like this, where it states the claim, claimed by maybe an authoritative site or figure, and you will see the fact-check status. This is the result of implementing the fact-check schema on a page, which we will share with you how to easily do it. But take note that there are some do's and don'ts for using the schema, which might affect your site's performance, and we're gonna talk about that as well. Let's go! Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. So when should you or should you not use the fact check claim review schema? Now the thing is, not all sites are suitable for the fact check claim review schema. If your site regularly publishes content that debunks myths, verifies claims, and analyzes statements, then the fact check schema is a no-brainer. However, do not use the fact check schema if you're writing an opinion piece like a review on a product or service. So unless your content evaluates claims and provides transparent, evidence-based conclusions, do not use the fact check claim review schema. Other than that, your site must have several pages marked with the claim review structured data, which means if your site has only one page marked with the fact check schema, and you do not see any pages that may be marked with the schema in the near future, you should not use the fact check claim review schema. This schema is designed specifically for sites that verify claims and debunk misinformation. This is the fact check schema guidelines by Google, by the way. We have left a link to this page in the description below. Next, there must not be any mismatch between the structured data and the page content. For example, you cannot have a false claim on your schema, and then on your page, it says that the claim is true. Both the schema and the content must align. There must not be any contradictions. Next, you must have a corrections policy or have a mechanism for users to report errors. For example, on this fact-checking site, the corrections policy is in the transparency page, and it says readers can submit corrections through the contact form. And then websites for political entities aren't eligible for this feature. Your content should be structured in a way that your readers can easily identify the claims and checks. You must clearly identify where the claim you're assessing originally came from. For example, on this fact check page, in the claim section, it has a link here that will bring you to the page where the claim was originally made. Now back to the guideline, and then you need to clearly explain how you arrive at your conclusions and provide evidence to back them up. For example, on the same page, it has written this content to explain how they derive at a conclusion, and right below you will see a list of its references. And then when it comes to the technical guidelines, you don't have to worry about them if you are using RankMath's fact check schema. But things to note are that the page where you add the fact check schema must only fact check one claim, and do not repeat the same fact check on multiple pages of your site. Which means when you fact check a claim on one page, do not create another page that fact checks the same claim. It is only logical. Now that you understand the do's and don'ts for the fact check claim review schema, let's talk about how to implement it. So to implement the fact check claim review schema on any of your pages, the first thing you need to do is to make sure that on your RankMath's dashboard, the schema structured data module is turned on. Following that, let's say that we have written this post to fact check a claim by the National Sleep Foundation that getting 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night improves overall health. And this is the page where the claim is made. So to add the fact check claim review schema, all you have to do is to click on the RankMath tab, select the schema option, and click on the schema generator. And the fact check schema is right here. Now let's talk about what to add to these fields. So the description field is where you provide a summary of the fact check you're performing. This is a mandatory field. Any field that is marked with this red asterisk is a mandatory field. Anyway, this description should clearly explain what the claim is and a summary of your evaluation. If you leave this field empty, RankMath will automatically pull the description from the SEO description field in the Edit Snippet tab. However, if you want to customize it, feel free to add your own tags. This is recommended. For example, in our case, we could write something like, "This claim states that 7 to 9 hours of sleep improves health and cognitive function. Scientific evidence supports this, linking adequate sleep to better memory, focus, and physical health. While individual needs may vary, the claim is mostly true based on current research." Keep the description concise and informative. Next, let's keep this review location and short code for now. I'll come back to this once we have added the information in all the schema fields. Let's move on to the rating field. Now, this works together with the rating minimum and maximum field. And we recommend keeping the minimum and maximum as the default, which is 1 and 5 to keep it simple. Now, the rating field will include your assessment of the claim as a rating score. Google will feature a textual value in the rich results. And this is based on the numeric value you provide in the rating field. For a rating scale between 1 and 5, 1 means the claim is false, the claim is entirely untrue. 2 means mostly false, which also means that the claim contains some truth, but it is largely inaccurate. 3 means half true, 4 means mostly true, just that there are some minor inaccuracies, and 5 means the claim is entirely accurate. In our case, I think this warrants a 4, because while the claim is mostly true, there are varying factors like the sleep quality of each individual. Next, we have the alternate name field. This is where you provide a human readable version of the rating score. For example, we have rated the claim as 4, which is mostly true. You can enter it here. Other examples include true, false, or half true, as we have talked about earlier. This helps users quickly understand your evaluation without needing to interpret the numeric rating. Next is the URL field. You need to enter the page URL where the claim is fact-checked. For example, since we are fact-checking the claim on this page, we can add the URL of this page in the field. This is a mandatory field, so make sure you don't leave it empty. Take note that the URL you have entered here should only contain one claim review element. For example, our page fact-checks only one claim, so it is eligible for the single fact-check rich results. But if your page fact-checks multiple claims, then this schema wouldn't work. Next, we have the author name field. This is where you enter the name of the person or organization evaluating the claim. It is a mandatory field, and by default, it uses the post author name. Anyway, assuming that I am a sleep expert with lots of credibility, I'm fact-checking the claim on my own site, I would enter my name or organization here. However, if it is someone else or an organization evaluating the claim on this page, for example, if you are a fact-checking site and you have invited other experts like the World Health Organization to fact-check the claim, you would add World Health Organization in the field. I hope this is clear. Next is the published date. This is where you enter the published date of this fact check or post. You don't necessarily need to add anything to this field because by default, it dynamically uses your page published date. But just for reference, if you need to add a date to this field, assuming it is on March 7, 2025, the date format will be 2025-03, which is the month, dash, and 07, which is the date. Next is the appearance section. This section lets you add details related to the claim itself. In the headline field, enter the headline of the claim you are fact-checking. This should be a concise summary of the claim. For example, in our case, the claim is 7 to 9 hours of sleep improves health and cognitive function. And we will add just that. This information will usually appear on the rich snippet so that users can easily see what the claim is. And then the URL where the claim was published. This could be a link to a news article, a social media post, a YouTube video, or any other source. For our case, this is the page where the claim was made. We can copy its URL and paste it here. Next is the author name, where you enter the name of the author making this claim. For example, if a claim was made by a politician named Jane Smith, you would enter Jane Smith here. If a claim is a widely shared social media message and you can't identify a specific author, you can enter social media users instead. But for our case, the claim is by the National Sleep Foundation, so we will add it accordingly. Finally, we have the published date field, where you enter the date when the claim was made or published. In our case, we can see that the published date on the page was March 5th, 2025. So we will apply the same format as earlier, which is 2025-03, which is the month, and 05, which is the date. Once we are done with the schema, let's click Save for this post. Now, we haven't talked about the review location field. We can add the schema detail, for example, below the content. Let's save this, save the post as well. And as we visit the page, the details you add to the fact-check schema markup will appear at the bottom of the page. So the review location field basically gives you the option to display the schema details in the position you want. But if you do not want to display the information or you want to add it to the location you desire, you would select the custom option. And this is the shortcode for you to paste anywhere on your page, so the details will appear at the location. But if you don't want to show the details, you don't need to paste the shortcode. Simple as that. And lastly, just make sure that whatever you have added to the schema fields are consistent with the contents of your page. Now let's quickly do another example. This time around, there is this person and many others on TikTok who claim that Walmart customers can receive a discount at self-checkout by entering a code seen above the front doors. And assuming that you have went to Walmart to fact-check the claim and it is completely false, now you have created this page to debunk the claim. Let's add the fact-check schema right here. For the description, we can briefly describe that the claim states that looking above Walmart's entrance doors for a 4-digit code can get you discounts at the self-checkout counters. We have verified and the claim appears to be false. Next, since the claim is completely false, we will put the rating as 1 and the alternate name will be false. And then the URL will be the URL of this page. Next, the author name will be myself, so I will not amend this. We will leave the publish date as well because it automatically takes the publish date of the post. Following that, we need to add the details of the claim. Let's describe the claim as Walmart customers can receive a discount at self-checkout by entering a 4-digit code seen above the front doors. Next, this will be the URL of the video where the claim was made. Let's copy the link and paste it here. And then the author name. You could add the social handle of this account. But since this is not the only account that made this claim, there are many more who shared this claim on social media, we could add social media users here. And finally, the published date of the claim. This claim was made on June 15, 2021. So over on the published date field, we will add 2021-June-15. Once done, let's hit save for this post and publish or save this page so that the schema will be applied. After adding all the information in the schema fields, it is the moment of truth. We have to test if the schema works. Testing any schema markups to see if it works is really simple. Just test your schema on the Google's rich results testing tool. So on the page you have added the fact check claim review schema, you want to right click on it and view its page source. And then I will Ctrl or Command A to select everything and Ctrl or Command C to copy the codes. Then go to the tool. This is the link. I would select the code option and paste the copied codes here and test it. Give it a while. And as you can see, we have passed this fact check schema test. And everything you have added in the schema fields are clearly added to the fact check claim review schema. Let's do the same test on the second example where the claim was to get the 4-digit discount code at Walmart's main door. And here we go. There is no issue with the schema, which means everything is in order. I hope you have a clear understanding of how and when you should implement the fact check claim review schema after watching this video. But if you still have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below and we will help you out. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.